Or the Guardian Angels, Curtis Sliwa is with us. Ro, by the way, I train mixed martial arts. I'm a student of arts. I've been training for 10 years, about an hour and a half a day, 4 or 5 days a week. What arts are you trained in, or art are you trained in specifically?
Western boxing, Brazilian jiu-jitsu. I'm a black belt in, and I'm also a judo practitioner.
So you have the skills necessary. Most people don't. So I guess you see this guy on the street, he's punching innocent people, random people, one after another. Nobody's lifting a finger to help him. And you step in and you tell people to call 911 and you apprehended this guy and kept him until the cops got there. Good for you. I applaud you being willing to put yourself on the line for innocent people.
Thank you.
Tell us what happened. What'd you see?
So I was on my way to work, running late because of the trains, and I was in Soho, and two men were walking towards me, two construction workers, just minding their business, probably on a lunch break, laughing and joking. And then out of nowhere, a third man walks behind him and literally sucker punches him in the side of the face. And I witnessed all this, and the man was able to fled off. And so I checked up to see how the construction worker was. He said he wasn't okay. And then two men walks up to us and said, he hit you too. So apparently what happened was this gentleman, or I shouldn't say gentleman, but this man hit several other people prior to him getting to this construction worker. So I immediately, they were like, we gotta stop this guy. And immediately my martial arts side camp kicks in, and I said, you know, yeah, we got to put this guy away, because in my mind, I'm thinking about my parents, because they're older, because he hit an old man, he hit a younger person. So what's to say he's not going to hit another person? So I literally, yeah. We all chased after him. I caught up to him. I literally just grabbed him, was able to take his back. I used the jiu-jitsu move called the seatbelt position. He tries to fling me off of him, and which helped me actually drag him to the ground, where I was able to subdue him in less than 30 seconds using my jiu-jitsu training.
Good for you. Curtis, you've been doing this all your adult life since founding. What year did you find you were the founder of the Guardian Angels? And by the way, all those years, the Guardian Angels were never armed, and you'd patrol the streets, the toughest areas in New York, the five boroughs. And you've had many an encounter yourself.
Oh, yes, both in New York, around the country, and around the world where we have Guardian Angels. First off, I'd like to applaud Ro. If I had been lucky enough to be elected mayor of the city and not Eric Adams, because I ran against him, you'd be getting the keys to the city, more importantly, as an example to other New Yorkers and Americans that it's time that we use our skills to fight back. If our elected officials will not enforce the law, if they won't let the police do their job and they've rendered them impotent, then we the people must fight back to use the skills to protect ourselves, our families, our merchants, our community.
Curtis,
that's the American way.
They're targeting elderly people. They're targeting people that don't have skills to defend themselves. I mean, look, I'm not as skilled as Ro, but I've been training for 10 years in a variety of arts and situational street fighting. You've been trained in it as well. Most people can't defend themselves, Curtis.
There's no doubt, but you look in our city, we now have the right, the constitutional right, according to the Supreme Court, if we qualify, to have a concealed permit like people do in other parts of the country. And yet our mayor, our governor, Adams and Hochul, are more afraid of the people becoming vigilantes and want to continue this victimization system. So by all means necessary, we the people must defend ourselves. I want criminals to be afraid of people. I want them looking over their back. In this case, look at the tender care he's giving this emotionally disturbed person who is a danger to himself and everyone else. Ro, on behalf of all of Americans, on behalf of Sean and everyone watching, I salute you and I encourage more Americans to do what you did. Get involved. Don't be apathetic. Don't just see something, say something. Do something, America. That's what America has always been about.
All right, Curtis, I applaud you as well. Ro, great job. Oos, and keep up the good work. And there's one less dangerous person on the street tonight. All right, we'll have more Hannity right after this.